Hello, this is Numeric Reviews, and welcome to my first TV show review. This video, I'm going to talk about Hawaii Five-0. Obviously, there'll be a spoiler warning now, because if you haven't seen the show, you probably should watch the show before watching this review. The show that was rebooted and renewed for 10 seasons is, in my opinion, one of my favorite TV shows. Though the original show had 12 seasons, the rebooted Hawaii Five-0 gave justice to the original by their choice in casting and crossing over with three different shows, NCIS, Los Angeles, MacGyver, and Magnum P.I. The show starts with the main protagonist, Steve McGarrett, portrayed by Alex O'Loughlin, hearing his father executed by Victor Hess, portrayed by James Marsden. He is then offered by the governor of Hawaii to start a task force on the island, and he first hires a detective who is new to the island, Danny Williams, portrayed by Scott Kahn. Steve and Danny then recruits an accused corrupt cop who Steve's father trusted, Chin Ho Kelly, portrayed by Daniel Dae Kim, and a new officer who is at the end of her training at the police academy, Kono Kalakaua, portrayed by Grace Park, who is the cousin of Chin. As the show progresses throughout the season, new characters join the task force and some leave the task force. The reason why I like Hawaii Five-0 is because of the way the show portrays the theme of family, or in Hawaiian, ohana. As the show progresses to the future seasons, the member of Five-0 increases and their friends also increases. That allows them to become like a family, which is why the theme of family is shown clearly in the show. Another reason that I like the show is because of the multiple famous guest stars that have been on the show. People like Nick Jonas, James Caan, the father of Scott Caan, Willie Garson, who most people know as Mozzie in the show White Collar, Wo-Yu Lee, Terry O'Quinn, Claire Vanderboom, Carol Burnett, Jerry Rice, Byron Chef, Zabit, and many others. Now I'm going to move on to my top seasons and top 10 episodes. Number 10, Season 8. Though I have enjoyed every season of Hawaii Five-0, Season 8 was the weakest of them all, as Daniel Dae Kim and Grace Park left the show over money disputes. The show had to create new characters to fill in. Though the new characters, Junior, portrayed by Beulah Koale, and Tani, portrayed by Megan Rath, were great, they couldn't fill in the shoes of Chin and Kono. The other issue with this season was the arc of Adam Noshimuri, portrayed by Ian Anthony Dale, Kono's husband, ended abruptly without any conclusion, making the viewers wonder what's next. Number 9, Season 7. Though this season had a one-way crossover with MacGyver, this season would have been in the number 10 list if it wasn't for Kono and Chin. The show tried to have a mysterious plot line with the serial killer out on the island. Even though this plot line was great, the show didn't spend much time on these episodes. What the show did was to spend the first four episodes of the show and a slight teaser at the end of the fourth episode, and left a huge plot hole at the beginning of the season. After wrapping up the serial killer arc, the show seemed to push both Kono and Chin out of the show with poor execution. Number 8, Season 6. After the death of Will Fat, portrayed by Mark Dacascos, the show had to fill the void with someone, which is why Gabriel Wincroft, portrayed by Christopher Sean, Chin's former brother-in-law, tasked himself to do just that. Making Gabriel the new Wolfat, in my opinion, was a big mistake. Though there were personal aspects to the antagonist, the character was never fully developed, which made it difficult to love the character as much as Wolfat. Another disappointing fact is that the show killed Gabriel off, which would have been understanding if Five-0 was the one who killed him, but no, it was a drug dealer who accidentally shot him and bled to death. Number 7, Season 3. Out of all the earlier seasons of Hawaii Five-0, Season 3 hits what I like to call the Season 3 curse. The main issue with Season 3 is Doris McGarrett, aka Sheldon, portrayed by Christina Latti. The arc of Steve finding out who his mother is disappointing, as they play the game of cat and mouse with Steve trying to get answers and Doris deflecting the question. The other disappointing part of the season is how Steve catches Will Fat. It was on a reality TV show, which meant the gruesome part was censored and there was no combat between Will Fat and Steve like season 2. Number 6, Season 9. Compared to Season 8, Season 9 is one of my favorite seasons in the back half of the show. The season brings a harsh reality that there are spies in the world spying on one another's countries. As the season progresses, the season gives an excellent departure for Joe White, portrayed by Terry O'Quinn, who dies in the 10th episode. This is also the season that 200 episodes airs, and the 200th episode is a perfect fit for what Hawaii Five-0 stands for. Number 5, Season 10. The final season of Hawaii Five-0 was by far the most intriguing season of the back half of the show. As the journey of Steve comes to an end, the season also ends multiple storylines that have been cultivated. The first best part of the season was the crossover with Magnum P.I., as Season 1 of Magnum P.I. had multiple cameos from Hawaii Five-0. Most fans, including myself, expected them to have an epic crossover this season, which they did. The other best part of the season was the fact that they brought a form of WoFat back, which was the best thing one could ever hope for. As the season came to an end, the show allowed Steve to understand what his father was working on and ends with Steve leaving the task force, which felt like a good ending for me as Steve got closure, and closure is all everyone can hope for. Number 4, Season 4. Season 4 of Hawaii Five-0 was way better than Season 3, as the show introduced Lou Grover, portrayed by Chi McBride, an ex-SWAT team captain from Chicago. The first half of the season gave the viewers a question of what happens if Five-0 and HBD are not in sync as Lou and Steve's issue become more complicated. The show also introduced a unique villain called Ian Wright, portrayed by Nick Jonas. Though he only makes 2 appearances, his terror is felt to me and the viewers while watching how much a computer can cause any harm. Number 3, Season 1. The season that started the entire show is, in my opinion, one of the greatest first seasons of any TV show, as the first season perfectly introduces the 4 Task Force members, but also the other core team members like Max, portrayed by Masioka, and Charlie, portrayed by Brian Yang. The season has a core intention on what the season finale is going to be, but with a spicy twist that leaves the fate of the Task Force in a limbo. Number 2, Season 5. In my personal opinion, as any show's 100th episode goes, Hawaii Five-0 had one of the most memorable ones. The season gave us many answers to the relationship between WoFat and Doris. To top this off, at the end of the season, there was a wedding between Kono and Adam, which gave the season some hope that was needed for the future seasons. Number 1, Season 2. Season 2 is by far my favorite season of Hawaii Five-0. With the introduction of Joe White and Laurie Weston, portrayed by Lauren German, the Five-0 Task Force work harder than ever to capture WoFat. As more answers are answered, there are more questions asked as the season unravels. With a crossover and cameo between NCIS LA, the crossover introduces a new type of comedy between the two shows. At the end of the season, the show answers the one big question about the identity of Shelburne. Now I'm going to talk about my top 10 favorite episodes. Since I can't speak native Hawaiian, I'm going to pronounce the titles in English. Number 10, The Future is in the Past, Season 8, Episode 10. This episode explores the concept of what if Steve and Danny retired, running their restaurants, and let the young kids take over Five-0. While in the present day, Danny is shot. As the episode continues with Danny's life on the line, the show explores multiple scenarios from Grace, Danny's daughter, and Will, Lou's son's wedding, Charlie's police graduation, Danny and Steve being very old, and etc. In my opinion, this episode used its unique style of writing and turned it into one of my favorite episodes. Number 9, For Queen and Country, Season 7, Episode 2. This episode introduces Harry Lanford, portrayed by Chris Vaughns, who, in my opinion, is one of the better returning characters from the back half of the season. Harry Lanford can be thought of as the British counterpart of Steve, as he has similar skills to Steve, but with a British accent and politeness. The way Five-0 and Harry work together, in my opinion, is one of the best moments in the season. Number 8, Touch of Death, Season 2, Episode 21. This episode crossed over with NCIS LA in a 2-part episode, as the episode explores the comedic dynamic between the Five-0 Task Force and NCIS LA team, it is fun to see the two team working together with some comedic tension. Number 7. The Entrance is Stopped with a Spider's Web, Season 6, Episode 24. This episode concludes the story arc of Gabriel Wancroft with a shootout in the street by the Yakuza. This episode shows how Five-0 is trying to help Gabriel get out of the Yakuza hit squad, and with Robert Coughlin, portrayed by Ingo Redimacher, finally putting his vendetta against Five-0 and helping them. Number 6. Where Were You When the Rain Was Pouring? Season 10, Episode 12. This episode is the crossover that fans have been waiting for ever since Magnum PI Reboot premiered in 2019. As fans witness the Five-0 Task Force and Magnum's friends work together, this episode explores whether a work relationship is a good thing and more Chinese spies. Number 5. Desperate Measures, Season 1, Episode 12. This episode explores where the line is for the Five-0 Task Force. Victor has blackmails the task force into giving him $10 million or a collar strapped on chin will blow up. As the governor refused to provide them with the money, which forces them to steal from the police impound, asking the question of what the task force is willing to cross to save their Ohana. And this is also the introduction of Wo Fat, the main antagonist of the series. Number 4. Gone on the Road From Which There Is No Returning, Season 9, Episode 11. Although the case Five-0 worked on is one of my least favorite cases, the main storyline allowed this episode to become one of my favorite episodes of all. As Steve, Danny, Catherine, portrayed by Michelle Borth, Wade, portrayed by David Keith, Jr., and Harry go after Joe White's killer, the team uniquely tackles every problem that is given to them and captures the target. Number 3. Aloha, Season 10, Episode 22. The series finale had many emotional moments with Steve deciding to retire from the task force and focus on his life, as he finally discovers what his father was working on before his death. As the show makes multiple references to the pilot, the show gives a proper send-off to Steve from the team and especially from Danny. Number 2. Pilot, Season 1, Episode 1. The show's pilot introduced the main four team members of the task force in a simple but elegant way. The episode showed each team member's key skills and how well they worked together as a team. As the show introduced how the Five-0 task force works with full immunity from the governor, the episode shows how hardcore the show will be for the future episodes. Now, here are some honorable mentions. Number 1. If Perhaps, Season 5, Episode 7. The 100th episode of Hawaii Five-0 is, in my opinion, the most memorable episode of the show. As Steve finally learns what Wofat's relationship is between Doris, the show gives a slight closure on Steve. The episode also explores what if Danny was on time to rescue John McGarrett, portrayed by William Sadler, and how that would have changed the history of Five-0. In conclusion, Hawaii Five-0 is an excellent show for those who like action-packed but also want to see a show with a theme of family. Those who like crossovers will also like it, as there will be more to watch after seeing that show. For those of you who are still watching this review, then thank you for watching and please subscribe. And I'll see you next time when I make a new video.